Hello and welcome everyone who is present in this state level lecture. And I am Shilpa Chhatravan from Vikrohi Parkside MPS Secondary School, Vikrohi West. And today we are going to study about lesson number 3, that is Life Processes in Living Organisms, Part 2. And whatever points are there, you can note down in your notebook, and we will learn this lesson in detail. Okay, so just we will start. So every living organism on the earth survives and strives for its life. All animals and birds, or insects, vultures, all live and strive for their life. We know that. We humans also struggle for our existence, and we also strive for our lives. Now, you see that humans today work as a machine, and means we see that we are, our whole day we are in front of computer or mobile, and we are just working like a machine. But can you think how this machine actually works? So is our body is like a machine, but how this machine works, that we know that our body works on a many organ systems like nutrition, respiration, transportation, digestion, nervous system, circulatory system, control and coordination, and all these systems work with coordination with each other. All these systems work with each other, and hence our body also works like a machine, which depends on all these systems. Okay, the all means whatever we respire, our lungs, what they do, they inhale oxygen and exhale the carbon dioxide, you know, and blood is also circulated through our transportation system, which is in each human body. And whatever, if we get hurt or if we have any pain, that nervous system coordinates with the brain, and we come to know about the pain at which part we are having. Okay, so in this way, whole body works like a machine. Now, another process called cell division also takes place in our body as an baby grows up to a grown-up person. With the help of cell division, this repeated cell division occurs in our body from birth of a newborn baby up to a well-developed or grown-up person. So we see here, when there is a newborn baby, it looks very small in size when it is given birth. But after some time, slowly it grows, and what happens there, that their cells get divided by mitosis, and the growth we see slowly the baby grows into a child, then it grows up into a grown-up person. Okay, so an pre-existing cell divides into two new cells, and thus this process continues with this new cells formed. They also divide into two, and this process continues again and again. Means if there is a, for example, there is one cell, it divides into two new cells, and that two new cells, then they again divide into again two new cells. So in this way, this process continues in the body and we grow, or the baby, for example, we have taken that newborn baby, it grows slowly by this repeated cell divisions. Now cell division also occurs with two types, that is meiosis and mitosis. Now about that we will study in detail in our further lectures, but today just make a note that cell division also occurs with two types, in this, in which meiosis after cell division produces four new cells and mitosis produces two new cells. Here in the figure you see meiosis, it produces four new cells, and mitosis, it produces two new cells. Now let's see the difference between meiosis and mitosis. Now meiosis, what happens in meiosis? Four cells are produced at the end of meiosis, just we discussed about that, and two cells are produced at the end of mitosis. So again, what is the difference between both? In meiosis, the chromosome number is reduced to half in each new daughter cell than the parent cell. Means, for example, if the parent cell number is 2n, n means any number, if it is 2n, then the daughter cells, it will be half, means only single n. Okay, so the number of cells will be reduced to half in daughter cells. So in meiosis, what happens? The chromosome number reduces. It reduces to half, means if it is one, it becomes half. If it is two, it becomes one. Okay, in meiosis, this process takes place. Now, in mitosis, the chromosome number in each daughter cell remains the same like the parent cell. Means if the parent cell has 2n number of chromosomes, then the daughter cells also have the same number of chromosomes. Means if it has 4 number of chromosomes, the daughter cells will also have 4 number of chromosomes. If it has 1 number of chromosome, the daughter cells also will have 1 number of chromosome. Means the chromosome number doesn't reduce in this process. It remains as it is as the parent cell. So this is the main difference of mitosis and meiosis. So we see what actually chromosomes are. You also must be thinking what is the chromosome, what are that. So in our previous ninth standard, we have studied about chromosomes. Okay, they are the spindle shaped structures which are present in our body. So these we have studied in our previous ninth standard science textbook. Okay, so as our body is made up of millions and trillions of cells, each cell has nucleus, and nucleus contains chromosomes which look like a spindle fiber, which have DNA strand compressed in them. So this is the DNA strand which is compressed in the chromosome. Okay, so DNA means what? DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. It is the long form of DNA. DNA's long form is deoxyribonucleic acid. So this DNA, what this DNA does? It does the process of protein synthesis, which is necessary for cell growth. So cells, what they require? They require proteins for the growth of our body. It means each cell requires proteins. So these proteins are provided by these DNA, what is does? It does protein synthesis, and thus the cells grow. Means they grow with the help of these proteins. So the DNA also passes specific instructions from parents to offsprings during cell division, which make each type of living organism unique. Means what happens, whatever the DNA is there in their parents, that is passed over to the offspring or the zygote which they produce, and that zygote or that offspring, it has some characteristics like similarities like their parents. So means they are transferred from parents to the offspring. Now, reproduction is the main process in every living organism. If we don't reproduce, then what will happen? Our species will get extinct. It will not be seen on the earth surface. So reproduction is the main process, and every living organism and humans, it gets maintained for the continuity of the species. And that of organism, it doesn't help the organism to remain alive, but it also important for their existence. Means if there is no reproduction, the species will get extinct. Means we will not see any organism, living organism, on the earth if it doesn't reproduce. Okay, so just we will see, there are two types of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Now, sexual reproduction requires male gamete and female gamete, which unite together and form a zygote. In this process, this is a sexual reproduction process in which it requires a male and a female to reproduce a new zygote. But in asexual reproduction, there is no gamete formation, means it doesn't require any male gamete or any female gamete. So, but new organism is formed with single parent. Means in asexual reproduction, what happens? Only a single parent is required for the reproduction. Now let's see in detail about asexual reproduction. So what happens in asexual? Only a parent is required. Two parents are not required, or two gametes are also not required. They reproduce singly. They don't reproduce by formation of male gamete and female gamete. So new organism is formed with the help of only single parent. Now, in asexual reproduction, the new organism formed has exact genetic similarity as that of parents. Means in this, what happens? The parents, the means what the genetic similarities means, the genes present in the parents are similar to the means the new organism formed by that, or the offspring which it is which it produces. Okay, the parent and the new plant. Okay, the parent plant and the new plant has exact same genes in them. Means we can't differ their genes from each other. So the parent, which genes the parent has, the same genes are present in the new plant also. So because of single parent, all the characters are copied by the new plant. As a single parent is involved in this type of reproduction, it is also called as uniparental reproduction. Uni means one. Only one parent is required. So this process is also called as uniparental reproduction, as only one parent is required in this process. Okay, now in asexual reproduction, there is absence of genetic recombination, means which is a drawback of this type of reproduction, means there is no genetic means the genes which are present in the parents, that same to same genes are transferred to the new generation or new organism or new plant. So this is the drawback of this type of reproduction, asexual reproduction. But this process happens very fast. What is the advantage of this process? Means this process happens very quickly. It doesn't require much time to reproduce new organism or new plant. So this is a fast process, and this is the advantage of this asexual reproduction. So as it is a mitotic division, the daughter cells are same like their parent cells. So in this process, only mitosis process, means mitotic division, takes place. Means the parent cell and the daughter cells, they have same number of chromosomes in them. So it is a mitotic division. Now just we will take an activity for our next means asexual reproduction. It is divided into three types of asexual reproduction are there. First one is binary fission, second one is multiple fission, and third one is the budding. But how this fission are done, for that we are going to take an activity for understanding the binary fission. So let us have a look of asexual reproduction in unicellular organisms. Now let us have an activity for it. For this activity, we require an conical flask. So in conical flask, what we will do, we will add water in it from a pond having stagnant water. Stagnant water means which is still, which doesn't flow. That still water we will take and we will add it in the conical flask. Now we will add some wheat grains to the conical flask. Wheat grains means of which we eat rotis and chapatis, that we will add to this conical flask. Then we will add some aquatic plants to it, means some aquatic plants means which are seen in water, that plants we will add in it. Now keep it for 3 to 4 days so that wheat grains and plants will decompose. Means what, after 3-4 days what will happen? It will decompose in that solution, means in that conical flask or in that water, it will decompose. Now on 4th day, what will we do? On the 4th day, we will take a glass slide and put a drop of that water over it with the help of a dropper. After putting it on the clean glass slide, we will carefully put a cover slip on that drop and observe this slide under the compound microscope. Now, what will we observe under the microscope? This is a microscope. So, we will observe that a fully grown paramecia is divided, it divides its body into two parts to form two smaller paramecia. So this we will see under the microscope. Now, here you will be able to see many paramecia performing the binary fission. Binary fission means it is it is dividing itself into two parts. Binary fission means division into two parts. Okay, so this type of fission is called as binary fission. And while doing this experiment, what you have to carefully note down that you have to strictly follow cleanliness during this entire activity. Means if we are using stagnant water, we are using the pond water, it can have some viruses or microorganisms in that. So while handling all this process, you have to take care, utmost care, and we have to do this experiment with extreme cleanliness. Okay, so wash your hands with soap after completion of the activity to prevent occurrence of any kind of infection. Means today we are we now know that how an virus is is become danger for our whole world. So for that we should take care. We should wash our hands properly, and due to which we will not suffer from any disease. Okay, so this is the precaution which we have to take during this experiment or activity. Okay, so prokaryotes like bacteria, proteins, like algae, paramecium, euglena, and eukaryotic cell organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, this all perform asexual reproduction by binary fission. All these organisms, these are unicellular organisms, and they perform binary fission. Okay, so in this process, what happens? The parent cell divides to form two similar daughter cells. So here in this figure, you will come to know how the parent cell gets divided into two daughter cells. It divides between the center and two cells are formed. So after binary fission, what happens? The parent cell does not exist any more. It will disappear. Means it will divide into two half first, and then two daughter cells are produced from it, and the parent cell disappears. Now binary fission occurs by mitosis or amitosis process. Means in this meiosis process is not seen, only mitosis process is seen in this type of fission. Okay, now axis of fission or division is different in different protists. Means the axis means it will be transverse or longitudinal or in any plane. That is the axis of fission. Means every protist divides in a separate axis. So in which axis which organism or protist divides, that we will see. Now just we will see the example of amoeba. Amoeba divides in any plane due to lack of specific shape. You know that amoeba is not having any specific shape, so it divides in any axis. It divides in a longitudinal, transverse, or any other plane, or it can divide its body into any type of fission. So it is called as simple binary fission. So it doesn't have any specific fission. So it is called as simple binary fission. This is the example of amoeba. Now next, if paramecium divides by binary fission, it will divide with transverse binary fission, means it will divide from the center of its body, and two paramecium, means two daughter paramecium cells will be formed from this. So this type of binary fission, it is called as transverse binary fission. Okay, now next one, Euglena. For the example of Euglena, it divides into two with longitudinal axis, means from top to the bottom. So it will divide like this in the figure, and two daughter Euglena cells will be formed. So this type of fission which takes place, it is called as longitudinal binary fission. Okay, so these three types of binary fission are seen in this protist, and binary fission is of three types. We have seen simple, transverse, and longitudinal. Okay, now we will move to next. Binary fission is usually performed by living organisms during favorable conditions, means binary fission, when it occurs, when there are favorable conditions, when there is plenty of food, plenty of water, that time this binary fission process occurs, when there is abundance of food and water. So when there is no favorable conditions, or no food or water, plenty of water or plenty of food, what happens? That time amoeba stops the formation of pseudopodia. Pseudopodia means the locomotory organs, that by with the help of that the amoeba makes its movement. So that time when there is no favorable conditions, or if there are adverse conditions for the growth, what the amoeba does, the amoeba stops the formation of pseudopodia, and thereby movements whenever there is a lack of food or any other type of adverse condition, and it becomes rounded and forms protective covering around plasma membrane. Means in the figure you see that this amoeba, first figure it has pseudopodia, and in the second figure it has become rounded. That it becomes rounded for protection. It forms a protective covering around the plasma membrane. Now such encysted amoeba or any other protist, it is called as cyst. Means this rounded protective covering, it is called as cyst. Now after that, what happens? Many nuclei are formed by repeated nuclear division. So you see in the third figure, what happens? There are so many nuclei present in that cyst. Okay, so this is, it is followed by cytoplasmic division, means its cytoplasm also gets divided with the nucleus, and thus many amoebulae are formed. Means so many amoebulae are formed. These are called as amoebulae. And they remain encysted till they are in adverse conditions. Means whenever there are adverse conditions, amoeba gets encysted, means it forms a cyst. And many amoebulae are formed in that cyst. And when there are favorable conditions, what happens? This cyst breaks. Means if there is abundance of water present, if there is abundance of food present, then what happens? The cyst breaks and opens on arrival of favorable conditions, and many amoebulae are released. Means these amoebulae are released while there are favorable conditions. And in this way, this process is completed. And this process is called as multiple fission. And after this multiple fission, the parent cell does not exist. Means it gets destroyed, or it is divided into these small amoebulae, and these amoeba is again formed. Okay. Now, unicellular organisms also perform asexual reproduction by budding. Now, how does this method of reproduction takes place? Let's see. Now, here, let's perform an activity to see how budding takes place in some unicellular organisms. Now, for this activity, we will take 50 ml of lukewarm water, means not so much cold or not so much hot. Lukewarm means normal water in a conical flask. And in that lukewarm water, we will add 5 grams of active dry yeast powder. Yeast that is used for making the for the purpose of bread. The bread has means how the it appears. For that, yeast is added in that bread. So this active dry yeast powder is added to this lukewarm water. Then 10 grams of table sugar is added to it, and then it is mixed well, and this flask is kept in a warm place for an hour. Means for an hour it is kept in a warm place, and after 1 hour, one drop of that mixture is taken on a clean glass slide. Okay. Now, after that, one cover slip is kept on that clean glass slide. Okay. Then it is observed under a compound microscope. Okay. So what will we observe? We will see that the yeast cell performing budding, that is a small bud coming out of many parent cells. Yeah, in this figure, you will see yeast reproduced by an asexual method called as budding. Now, asexual reproduction occurs by budding in yeast and unicellular fungus. Okay, so the yeast cell reproduces 2 daughter nuclei by mitotic division. Here you will see in the figure, 2 daughter nuclei are seen. Okay, by mitotic division, it reproduces by this budding process. Now, this yeast cell is called as parent cell. So this one is called as parent cell, and these are the daughter nuclei which are formed here. Now here, a bulge, a small bulge which appears on the surface of the parent cell. You will see a bud-like or bulge-like structure on the upper surface of this cell. So it is called as a bud. A small bulge appears on the surface of the parent cell. This bulge is actually a bud. Okay. Now one of the 2 daughter nuclei enters this bud, and after sufficient growth, the bud separates from the parent cell. Now, what happens? This daughter yeast cell after sufficient growth, what it does, it will means it will separate from the parent cell and live a means independent life, and will what after separation from parent cell, it starts to live independently as a daughter yeast cell. So in this way, today we have seen about asexual reproduction, how this asexual reproduction takes place, and we have seen whatever we have seen, just we will overlook whatever we have seen in our today's lecture. So we have seen binary fission, binary fission, again we have seen how that axis, in which axis all the organisms are divided from with each other. So these amoeba, this is binary fission, multiple fission, and budding, these are the main processes in the asexual reproduction of unicellular organisms. So just we will have a look on this binary fission. So the amoeba, it divides in any plane, so it is called as simple binary fission. Okay, so it doesn't have any specific shape, so it divides in any plane, so it is called as simple binary fission. Now the paramecium, the paramecium, it divides by transverse axis, so it is called as a transverse binary fission, as you see in the figure. Okay, and the euglena, it divides by longitudinal binary fission. From the top to bottom, it gets divided, and two new daughter euglena are formed. So it is called as longitudinal binary fission. And in multiple fission, we have seen that amoeba, it gets encysted and it produces a cyst, a rounded shaped cyst, and many nuclei and amoebulae are formed, and after favorable conditions, it releases all the amoebulae. And this, in this process, multiple fission process occurs. Okay, and in broad budding, we have seen that how the parent cell and the daughter nuclei, it divides mitotically, and a bulge or a bud is formed, and after sufficient growth, it separates from the parent cell, and it means it grows independently. Okay, so in this way, we have seen, means today we have learned about asexual reproduction in unicellular organisms. In our next lecture, we will discuss about multicellular organisms and asexual reproduction, how it takes place in multicellular organisms in detail. Okay, so hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello, ma'am.
हेलो मैम,
हेलो।
हेलो मैम,
हाँ हेलो बेटा।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा।
मैम वो बर्डिंग मतलब क्या है मैम?
बर्डिंग मीन्स इन दिस प्रोसेस व्हाट हैपन्स, अ बल्ज मीन्स मीन्स अ आउटवर्ड ओपनिंग इज प्रोड्यूस्ड विच अपियर्स ऑन द सर्फेस
यस
ऑफ द
मैम,
पैरेंट सेल। नाउ दिस बल्ज इज कॉल्ड एज अ बड। ओके
ओके ओके, थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू मैम।
ओके। अगेन एनीवन एनीवन वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग?
हेलो मैम।
हाँ हेलो मैम।
हेलो,
हाँ यस मैम। हेलो
हेलो मैम,
यस
इज इट
मैम।
कंप्लीटेड?
ओके यस मैम।
ओके देन
यस मैम। वाइंड अप मैम।
वाइंड अप। ओके थैंक यू मैम।
ओके।